Hello guys, welcome to Bhavna's Online Academy. So as you would have read in the title, today we are going to discuss CA Inter Paper Number 5 Advanced Accounts Exam Analysis. So in this video, I am going to analyze the past 7 attempts and give you the most important chapters based on this exam analysis. Along with that, I'll provide you a sure shot strategy of how you can score 70% or 70 plus marks in your exams without much effort. And along with that, we'll also discuss how to study and prepare for your advanced accounts, means which book you should refer, what are the videos available on my channel which you can take help from, and apart from that, at the end, we'll also discuss the question paper pattern. So without any further ado, let's get into the video, guys. Yes. So as you can see here, we have the past exam analysis in front of you. So here I have analyzed from November 2019 till November 2022. That is 7 attempts of papers I have analyzed, and that too chapter wise breakup of all of these chapters are given here, right? So as you can see on the screen, every attempt 125 marks of questions are being asked, out of which 100 marks question you have to attempt. So based on this analysis, I have made a category of category A, B and C, which is the important and the not so important list of chapters, and let's start to discuss that. Yes. As you can see below, there is an ABC analysis given here, where what I have done is I have sorted chapters into 3 categories, category A, category B and category C. Your category A are your important questions or important chapters rather, which is marked in blue color, which will carry a weightage of around 75 marks. Category B chapters are given in yellow color, which carry a weightage of 30 marks. Or category C chapters are marked red and they will have a weightage of 20 marks in the examination. Yes, hope you are clear with this. So let's start by first discussing the blue mark chapters, which are your category A chapters, or rather we can say which are your 75 marks coverage chapters. So as you all know, in your examination, in your advanced accounts examination, accounting standards is definitely going to come in your question number 1, which is your compulsory question. So 4 questions of 5 marks each are going to be asked in your exam, and all those 4 questions are going to be from accounting standards. And apart from that, in your question number 6 also, minimum at least 1 accounting standard question is being asked in every attempt. So a total of around 30 marks of weightage has been given to accounting standard in every attempt. So it is very, very important that you cover this accounting standards, all your accounting standards which are there in your advanced accounts paper, so you can fetch this 30 marks in your examination. So accounting standards is very, very important, and this is again important because it comes in compulsory question, and if you skip that question, 20 marks are gone then and there. You cannot fetch it using any other question, right? So please make sure you cover your accounting standards first. And to help with your accounting standard preparation, as you can see on the left side of your screen, I've created a playlist and all the videos related to your group 2 accounting standards have been uploaded there. I'll provide the link of the accounting standard playlist in the description box below. You can definitely check out that. It will very much help you in the preparation of your examination. After your accounting standards, the next important chapters, which is your category A chapters, are your partnership accounts, ESOP, buyback and CFS. So your ESOP and buyback you have to definitely do for examination, because consistently in the examination they have been asked. Yes, ESOP has come for consistently from around 5 to 10 marks, that is 5 marks rather I can say, and buyback has come for consistently around 10 to 20 marks. So an average weightage of 6 marks or 5 marks ESOP will carry, an average weightage of 13 to 15 marks your buyback will carry. So ESOP and buyback you have to definitely do and go. Apart from that, there are few students who feel partnership is easy and there are few students who feel CFS is easy. If you are someone who can do both, then please cover both and go. That will be very, very good. Or else what you can do is, see, in every attempt partnership is being asked for around 15 to 20 marks, and the same for CFS. In every attempt 15 to 20 marks it is being asked. So partnership and CFS comes in your examination for around 25 to 30 marks. Correct. In a total, you can say 25 to 30 marks, it will come for a minimum. So what you can either do is, since you have optional question pattern in your examination and each question is either around 15 to 20 marks or 15 to 20 marks, I mean CFS is around 15 to 20 marks. So these both questions cannot come as a single question. These both chapters questions cannot come as a single question, because the maximum weightage of one question in your examination is 20 mark only. either in this 20 mark they'll ask you partnership or CFS. So even if this both chapters are being asked in your exam, it will come as two separate questions only. It is going to come as two separate questions only, correct? So in such case, what you can do is, even if you prepare one, either you prepare partnership or either you prepare CFS well, what you can do is, one question you can leave as optional and the other question you can attend. One you can leave as optional and other you can attend, correct? So if you feel both partnership and CFS is difficult, or either one of it is difficult, it's okay. For your examination, you need not give that much importance to one chapter, as one chapter you can skip in the exam as an optional question and the other you can attend. Okay, so this strategy we can follow for partnership and CFS. So what is included in your category A? Accounting standards, ESOP, buyback. And apart from that, if you can do both partnership and CFS, well and good, because both will be asked in every attempt for 15 to 20 marks. If you feel, no, I feel both are difficult or one is difficult, then you can skip one and prepare the other and leave the other one for your optional question. Yes, so this is about your partnership accounts and CFS, that is also included in your category A. So the most exciting part about this category A chapters is that I have uploaded videos related to all the category A chapters. That means accounting standards, I've already told you it is uploaded. Now if you see on the left side of your screen, your advanced accounting playlist is running, where I've uploaded ESOP along with the concepts and sums from your ICA textbook. Same for buyback, concepts and sums I've uploaded. Partnership also, all the four methods of partnership along with sums I've uploaded. And apart from that, CFS concepts I have uploaded. So all the category A chapters, so all your category A chapters videos you will find on my channel. You need not go anywhere. This is more than enough for your preparation for the exam. Go and find that playlist link below in my description box and you can prepare all your category A chapters. Yes, and definitely you'll be able to score. As you can see here, the weightage of category A, it comes for around 60 to 75 marks in the exam and an average weightage of 67 marks. So definitely 70 marks of your exam marks will be secured if you watch this video and practice the sums. If you watch this video and practice the sums. Okay, so that was about your category A chapter. And your category B, let's talk about category B chapters, which will come for 30 marks in your examination, which will be your banking, NBFC and amalgamation. So your banking and NBFC, in every attempt, almost in every attempt, again it has come, banking has come for around 10 to 15 marks and NBFC has come for around 5 to 10 marks. So these both, inclusive of these both, around 12 to 16 marks in every attempt you'll be able to see. Around 12 to 16 marks, these both chapters in every attempt you'll be able to see. So make sure you practice this both as your category B. Along with that, do your amalgamation also, because it carries an average weightage of 12 marks in your examination. So all these three chapters included, you will get a weightage of around 30 to 35 marks in your exam, least being the 30 marks in your exam. So next is category B chapter, which is amalgamation, banking and NBFC. After you have prepared all of this, at the end, if you have time, prepare internal reconstruction and liquidation also. Internal reconstruction is not so important, as you can see from your weightage alone. In any one attempt, if your bad luck is there, they'll ask in the examination like they did in the previous attempt. Okay, so usually it is not being asked in every attempt. And if you see liquidation is being asked in every attempt for 5 to 10 marks around. For also, you know that for liquidation and as well as amalgamation also, I've uploaded videos. Kindly refer that also in my channel in the same advanced accounts playlist. Okay. So liquidation is also being asked in your examination. But see, first prepare your category A, because carries the most weightage. Then a little less weightage is your category B. And finally, category C, you can prepare case. Okay. So this is how I've categorized your category A, B and C. Category A, if you study 75 marks short. Category B is 30 marks short. Category C is 20 to 25 marks short. So please make sure you prepare accordingly. And if you have any doubts related to this, let me know in the comment section below. Yes. So now next, moving on, after we have discussed your ABC analysis, let's discuss your question paper pattern. So if you see your question paper pattern here, so totally question number one you are being asked in your exam. Each question will be question for 20 marks in your exam. Okay. Question number one is your compulsory question, which will be asked from your accounting standards, and it can be asked from any of these accounting standards. Yes. So prepare all these accounting standards and prepare all the sums related to this accounting standards also. Once you're done with this, next you will be given 5 questions, out of which only 4 questions you will have to attempt. One question you can leave as optional. Yes. every question will come for 20 marks. So if you attend any four from this plus this one question, 100 marks total you will get in your examination. And to specifically talk about question number 6 in your examination, question number 6 will consist of 5 questions, out of which only 4 you have to attempt, and each will be for 5 marks each. So again, that will also tally for 20 marks. In this question number 6, one question usually comes for theory. Usually there'll be one question which is related to theory. So if you're planning to leave out one question as optional, you can leave out that theory question. Prepare your advanced accounts paper as your practical paper and go. Yes, only 5 marks theory will be question in your examination, which you can leave also. That wouldn't create an issue. So that is your question paper pattern. Yes. And finally, what is the best way to study? What is the best way to prepare your advanced accounts is what we are going to understand. So first, you have to prepare all these sums or illustrations and practical problems. Illustrations as well as practical problems you have to prepare from your ICI study material. Prepare it for minimum, try to prepare it for 2 times, okay? Try to practice it for minimum 2 times. After you have done your ICI study material, for category A chapters, your buyback, ESOP, partnership, CFS, and your accounting standard, look after the past 10 attempts question also. Look after your past 10 attempts question also. Your RTP and MTP questions, you have to try to practice it. And along with that, for category B and C, past 3 to 4 attempts RTP, MTP, if you practice it is enough. For category A, last past 10 attempts RTP, MTP. For category B and C, last 3 to 4 attempts RTP and MTP would suffice. Yes, so this is how you have to prepare for your advanced accounts paper. If there is any question, please do let me know in the comment section below. Hope this video was helpful and beneficiary to all of you. If it was, do let me know in the comment section below, because it acts as a source of motivation for me to keep uploading such useful videos for you all. Yes. Before leaving, please make sure to like, share it with your friends and subscribe to the channel. See you in the next video, guys. Bye-bye.